Wow, that's not phallic at all, is it?
Well, not now, but wait till it gets to 20 feet.
Right. So we've got Procter & Gamble coming out and the supply, etc.
So,
Prostate Cancer Charity had a non-public one, which is Caravan. So today is the Procter & Gamble day.
But here with me are a few of the riders, including one of the organisers, Hugh Roberts. So Hugh, just tell us a bit about what is it you're doing? How did this all come about? What are you doing?
This all came about because we're the sort of custodians and organisers of the big pro race in this country, the Tour of Britain. Lots of different people. On the first day, for example, when we started in Seaton, East Devon, we had Tristan Gemmell from Casualty who joined us. He's a keen cyclist. We've got a group of people from Procter & Gamble. There's about 15 to 20 of them who are all joining us. They're all shapes and sizes, genders, and some will go quick, some will go slow, but it's great to have them joining us for the day. But
you will have gone to the lengths that Mike Sweeney has. Mike, I gather you're joining us from Melbourne. What's brought you over from Australia to do this run?
Thank you, Alex. Last year in Australia I organised a ride similar to this one, but it was across Australia. Again, it was to raise the awareness and funds for prostate cancer. And when I heard of this ride, and also the significance of proving that prostate cancer, like cycling, has no international barriers, I was more than willing to come on and participate, support, spread the message, whilst having a good look around the UK.
My name's Claire and I work for Procter & Gamble over in Weybridge in Surrey, and we're here to cycle for a whole day.
Hi. I'm Jill, I'm from British Airways and I'm here to cycle from here to Burnham-on-Crouch.
Yeah, we're doing it for Caravan and prostate cancer.
My name is Andy Hawes and I work for Sweet Spot, the organisation behind the Great Tour of Britain. But I am the stage finish manager for the Tour of Britain.
Legs there, you're a keen cyclist.
I am indeed, yes.
Yeah, and you've made the ultimate sacrifice of shaving your legs.
Incorrect.
Yeah.
So we're from Procter & Gamble and we wanted to sponsor Caravan, who are sponsoring this great tour. We also really fancied a challenge of a cycle ride for a day on a beautiful day as it is today.
Yeah.
So we're delighted to be here. We can't wait to get started and hopefully we'll feel the same at the end of the day.
Fantastic.
I'll let you know at the end of the day.
Yes, we are coming from Belgium with a bicycle to see the beautiful landscape of England.
The very beautiful landscape of England.
James, I really need them all.
To youth hostel and you guys were over there and we start speaking with the organizer. And they offer us a free meal for doing the dishes. We ask if we can go on your bicycle trip because we do charity.
We want to like to say hello to the
Santa Claus.
And to the president of Europe, the Belgian guy. Well, Van Rompuy.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the English dude, Nigel Farage, said he was a loser.
A loser, a nobody. Yeah.
A nobody, yeah. And a towel.
But you like him.
No, I don't like it.
Is that a bit?
Yeah. No, I'm working camera.
Okay, yeah, that's right. Great, the great tour nights, yeah.
Wait,
it's going very well there. In the
are
bill.
Are you videoing this? I thought you were taking a photo of me.
I can take a photo as well if you want.
All right on the flat. Right on the flat.
Yeah.
As soon as the hills start, that's it.
It's mostly flat though.
I hope so.
If you think it's got to be, hasn't it?
Well, I think what you guys think is flat, I think is a hill. That's my problem.
So, hello. What's your name?
Daniel.
And what's your job on this trip?
I'm a cameraman.
And normal, you take the pictures of people.
Yeah.
Do you want to say something to all the people in the world?
Yeah. I love you, Mum. Well done to Prostate Cancer Charity. Stop eating for a bit.
Huh?
All the good work that they've done helped me in my various movie making things.
Uh-huh.
And long may it continue, and also Caravan, who I don't really know. But they seem like good people as well.
So you're eating because you're depressed?
And the origin of Pringles is we make paper towels in the US, and to make paper towels you shove trees in one end of a factory, mush them all up with paper, flatten them and dry it really quickly, and then you get paper towels. But we weren't using all the capacity of the plant, so we decided what else could you put in there and, you know, do the same thing. So we put potatoes in at one end, mush them all up with water, flatten them, dry them, cut them out, and that's how Pringles was born.
No,
that is true story.